What's up, Cardboard Nation? We are back live and better than ever after a week's hiatus. We hope you had an enjoyable 4th of July, even though it fell on a very weird day this year. I'm Rob Bertrand, voice of the collector. Joining me, as always, that guy over there, Ivan Lovgren at Watch the Breaks on Twitter.
Welcome, Rob.
Follow me at VOTC. Hey, buddy, what's going on, man?
Oh, so much is going on. Twitter has been popping. Lots of people excited. We're doing so much on the show tonight. I cannot wait to get started. We're here and we are started. Let's go.
Well, let's talk about it. We've got a couple things to announce. First, I still have 6 tickets to the National Sports Collectors Convention. We will give away a pair to a lucky viewer towards the end of the show. Following next week, we'll give another pair away. And after that, the week before or week of, I think we'll give away. Oh no, the week before we'll give away one more.
Hey, if you missed
thank you to the guys at the National for providing those for our audience. In addition, and this is pretty cool, as Joe's going to show you, we want to make sure that you guys are aware of an awesome opportunity. To win a pair of VIP passes, which comes with a meet and greet opportunity with the one and only Bears Hall of Fame legend Dick Butkus, and a behind the scene tour of happenings at the National. So it's the Dick Butkus VIP meet and greet sweepstakes. You can go to nsccshow.com to register. That is open until July 23rd, so you have plenty of opportunities to register for that. Don't miss out. Be sure to take advantage of that.
If there's ever a time on the show where I don't need to speak for 45 seconds, I'm going to be registering for that giveaway.
There you go. And as a little caveat to that, I don't know if it's any sort of bonus, but apparently longtime Chicago sports broadcaster with NBC News, Chet Kopick, and I will be on hand during that meet and greet session, talking with Dick and facilitating that whole thing.
Wow.
So, looking forward to that.
Very exciting. So you're saying I might be able to get in just to watch, even if I don't get to
go. I think so. Selfie. Here's a rundown of what we got going on the rest of the show. We've got a very engaging and lengthy hobby happenings segment tonight. Lots going on. We'll take a look at next week's new sports card releases with Hot in the Shop. We have a flash break video to show you of 2017 Topps Walking Dead Season 6. And then live, we'll be breaking over $800 worth of product tonight.
Wow.
So Rob, sit down, strap it in.
I didn't want to call you out, but I'm like, no guests? I know that Hobby Happenings is a little long between all the stuff that's happened in the last 2 weeks, and even still, I think most of it's just this past week, really, that we're touching on. But no guest? What's up with that? And then I looked at the boxes, and this is ridiculous. Including, can I spoiler alert it? Can I give some away?
Sure.
So including another box. Didn't we open one box of this already? Or am I crazy? Of 2017 Topps Museum Collection Baseball Cards? Did we open a box already? Or am I just so overwhelmed with all the boxes that I'm getting confused now?
I think you're so overwhelmed with all of the boxes.
Okay, great. Well, and it's been one that I've been seeing a ton of hits from online. Seemed really popular this year. So that's going to be exciting. Panini Torque Racing Cards, which I've been waiting for a while to see all of those
nice
metal bits and pieces. It's like a car shop in this product. Donruss Elite NFL Football Cards, is that the one with the Pin Pals autos? That'd be fun.
Yeah.
And then
you did pretty well last year.
The one that I'm most excited for out of all of those, I never would have thought I would have said this until we opened their most recent box and we've seen the changes that they've been making to upgrade their products. 2017 Sage Autographed Football Cards. which we previewed 2 weeks ago on the show. This is a rookie heavy product with the chance at some dual autos and triple autos, I believe, of veterans, including
just dual autos.
Just dual autos, including
prolific pairs.
Prolific pairs.
Kind of like this one that I have that we will be giving away later tonight. This is from last year's edition.
Look at that.
This is a personally signed Dak Prescott, Ezekiel Elliott, dual auto, limited to 20 copies.
Now, call me crazy. I thought that was from this year's. I thought that was where.
Nope. This is from the 2016's version.
Okay. Because I know that the. Aren't the prolific pairs non rookies?
Nope.
I'm pulling back up the.
They're rookies.
Because I thought when we went over this, I saw that.
You're all confused. You're a hot mess, dude.
I am all confused, but it's because we're opening over $800 worth of product today.
You're giddy.
I've still got, like, my Twitter is still popping off with people arguing about this other stuff. And it's like, who cares? Pause for a minute. Get in here. Argue in this chat room and have a chance to win some sweet cards and see what else is going on in the hobby.
There you go.
I'm going to engage quickly with these people and tell them, hey, watch the show. So you take over. Oh, and also real quick, if you want your chance to win that as well as the National Sports Collectors Convention tickets, go to our Twitter. We actually did pre-show tweets for entry. So you got to go retweet the tweets that are there that show the card and the ones and says retweet and enter. And same with the National Show tickets. So go ahead and do that. Please do, though, if you're entering for the National, please make sure that you can actually attend. Be respectful. This is one place where we ask our hobby family to all just stick together and do what's right.
That's right. And we are hearing that there are some echo issues. We were dealing with that pre-show. Our producer, Joe Fallon, is working behind the scenes to try to effort that issue. Just blame it on Ivan. I can tell you that.
It's all my
fault.
I like hearing myself so much that I'm hearing myself.
Hearing yourself twice. But let's shift gears and dive right into it because we got a lot of talk about in this edition and segment of this week's Hobby Happenings. All righty. So here's a look at what's going on this week. We kick things off with news that should have some Star Wars collectors absolutely giddy. This week, Topps announced that they have signed Hayden Christensen, to an autograph deal. The actor played Anakin Skywalker and has not been in a Topps trading card product in over 10 years. Look for his autographs in 2017, Topps Star Wars Masterwork, releasing this November.
Well, Rob, Aaron Judge set another record this week. Not on the field, mind you, but regarding his baseball cards. Tuesday, this Chrome Prospects autograph of the young Yankee slugger from 2013 Bowman draft sold on eBay for $14,655. Now, while it didn't even come close to the 20K sticker price for the gold refractor that sold a couple of weeks ago, it is the eighth five-figure sale of an Aaron Judge auto in the last month. So, now, as crazy as that is, it's still nothing on the $30,000 Chris Bryant Leaf one of one he just sold. But we'll give Aaron Judge some props for doing that, you know, with a licensed product.
And as many of you know, it appears that Dak Prescott might have some explaining to do. A heated thread on the Blowout Forum this week discusses the Dallas Cowboys quarterback's alleged use of an auto pen to sign stickers used in 2016 Panini Prism football. Some collectors waiting on those autographs, which were inserted in the product via redemption, discovered that their ship packages had been recalled by Panini. The story has now made national news thanks to a story by Darren Revelle at ESPN. We have reached out to company officials to determine if they have any additional information into this particular situation. We are still waiting for a reply. Mm-hmm. However, based on the way Panini has handled previous issues, collectors should be assured that an equitable solution to the circumstances surrounding these allegations, if necessary, will be forthcoming. We'll provide an update to the story as soon as we have information from Panini on the GoGTS.net blog once an official statement is made. Feel free to talk amongst yourselves in the chat room.
Speaking of which, Pete Rose, Major League Baseball's all-time hit king, may be banned from baseball and barred from induction into the Hall of Fame, but he still has plenty of fans and collectors willing to pony up for his memorabilia. This past week, Leland's sold the actual ball Rose hit to break Ty Cobb's hit record for over $403,000. I'd just be curious how they authenticated it.
Ivan, I hate to say it, but the rash of burglaries targeting sports card and memorabilia dealers in Minnesota apparently isn't over yet. We first brought you this story a few months ago after three businesses in the area of the Twin Cities were hit in less than 2 weeks. This past week, longtime dealer Bob Krawitz, owner of the Ninth Inning, was the victim of a break-in that saw over $200,000 in vintage cards stolen in what police believe was a targeted professional burglary. Thankfully, the theft occurred around midnight, well after the business was closed for the day. No one was hurt, but man, do people suck.
Rob, I couldn't agree more with that. Topps has announced an extensive array of plans for the coming week's Major League Baseball All-Star Fan Fest, which kicks off in South Florida tonight. Attendees can take advantage of a great rapper redemption program showcasing top MLB stars. This year's exclusive six-card set features Mike Trout, Clayton Kershaw, Chris Bryant, Buster Posey, Bryce Harper, and Giancarlo Stanton. And I believe four of those six guys are All-Stars. Simply open three packs of 2017 Topps baseball products at their booth to get your free set. Purchase of a complete factory set gets you one of the always popular limited edition commemorative patch card. Ooh, look at that. You can also participate in Pack Wars for prizes. Get a sneak peek at Stadium Club Baseball when the guys from ripandwax.com facilitate several box breaks live on site. You can test out Topps Bunt, make your own trading card, and much, much more. Man, I wish I was going. Is that in the budget somewhere?
Speaking of the All-Star Game, Philadelphia Phillies pitcher and collector himself, Pat Neshek, has some goals for his PC while he's down there. ESPN ran a great piece this week detailing his plans to get an elusive signer added to his autograph collection in the form of Zach Greinke. He said, "I'm going to have my kid run over there. His son Garrett is 3.5, so if Greinke can say no to him, I guess no one stands a chance." Neshek signs through the mail and actively engages with collectors on Twitter. Give him a follow, at Pat Neshek.
And finally, Rob, remember the Babe Ruth 1927 World Series ring and Curse of the Bambino contract that came to auction through Leland's last time we spoke?
Mm-hmm.
Well, Rob, it turns out that they were owned and consigned by none other than Hollywood bad boy and noted baseball memorabilia collector Charlie Sheen. Despite accounts to the contrary that Sheen decided to part with the items due to cash flow issues, the sale price for both items of over $4 million means that Sheen is, once again, winning!
Well, not so fast, Ivan. Actually, the sale of that World Series ring allegedly awarded to Ruth for the Yankees' 1927 championships was not without a lot of skepticism, criticism, and allegations of downright fraud. An extensive and very well-researched article on the website Halls of Shame provides ample evidence that the ring consigned by Sheen and sold by Leland's is nothing short of a forgery. What? Even Ruth's granddaughter, Linda Ruth Tassetti, was quoted as saying, "You'd have to be blind to not see that Sheen's ring was engraved by someone else. It isn't even close to the real ones I was shown that belonged to my grandfather's teammates." Okay, so
more fraud.
What is she talking about? Well, Leland's Auctions is claiming that the ring was originally acquired from Claire Ruth, Babe's widow, by disgraced and now deceased collector Barry Harper. The auction house has also made claims that the G.H. Ruth engraving inside the ring perfectly matches the few other original player rings of the 1927 Yankee players. However, upon close examination, the engraving on the alleged Ruth ring greatly contrasts other genuine 1927 player rings. As you can see, the engraving found on the genuine rings of Miller Huggins and Mike Gazzella contrasts the questioned G.H. Ruth engraving on the left. In particular, notice that the capital G engraved on the Gazzella and the capital H on the Huggins illustrate that the Ruth ring does not, quote, perfectly match other players' rings as claimed by Leland's. Hand engravers and another owner of a genuine 1927 World Series ring all agree that Sheen's Ruth ring engraving does not match that of Huggins and Gazzella rings. In particular, those capital H and G's on all three rings highlighted in red here on this black and white image of the three examples. And if you wanted more proof or evidence that this ring is bogus, note that other Yankees players' rings engraved with initials each included period marks after the capital letters, but are mysteriously absent in Ruth's example. And that's a look at this week's hobby happenings. Always something in our hobby, isn't it?
What are we going to do, Rob? What are we going to do?
It's just keep passing the buck, I guess.
I'm just staring at these and comparing it. I'm no expert, though apparently everybody is now, on autographs and engravings. And I say that only partially lightly because some things are just kind of obvious to the naked eye. So what I think this means is that we need to get either Andy Broom or Steve Grad or another top authenticator back on the show just to talk about that side of the business, because I know that there's too much still up in the air on certain things to go deep into it, but I think it'd be good maybe by next week to try and get one of those guys on here to sort of talk about what it is that they see that's verifiable and that gives us a little hope, because today it's seeming like we need some.
Absolutely. Absolutely. So, hey, let's take a look at what's popping next week in a little segment we like to call Hot in the Shop, a look ahead at next week's new product releases, because then after that we get to look at some box breaks. What do you think of that?
I like it, especially with what we're kicking off with. Already teased in hobby happenings. So jealous of the guys at Rip and Wax for their initial preview. Hopefully we'll get this next week.
Right, Rob, it's a favorite.
Tee it off with everybody's favorite product.
All right. Well, here's a look at what everybody's one of their favorite products. 2017 Top Stadium Club baseball cards, known for its overwhelming use of just most amazing photography. Stadium Club is going to deliver two autograph cards and a combination of 16 parallels and inserts in every box. Captivating photography that captures a wide array of beautiful images from the MLB season. Base card shots include game-changing plays, player celebrations, fun moments, and iconic retired players. This year's release will be highlighted by base chrome parallel cards of today's must-have MLB superstars. The 16 parallels and inserts, the combination thereof, should fall to find two black foil parallels, a chrome parallel, two power zone inserts, the always popular beam team insert, and two scoreless streak inserts as well. You know, Ivan, I love them case hits, and look for plenty of those as well. Four chrome refractor parallels, two gold insert parallels, one gold minted parallel, four black and white parallels, and one InstaVision insert.
That's what I'm looking at right now. Andrew.
Base autograph cards are signed on card. Woohoo! Yes. And foil parallels in gold, number to 50, black, number to 25, new this year, rainbow, number to 10, hobby only, and gold 101s. check out the rest of the details for yourself, because you can just get crazy. There's 50 base card variations. The Power Zone insert, inserted 1 and 8, is inspired by that famous 1990s insert set and highlights batters who make hitting the long ball look effortless. This is just a fun product year in and year out, and can't wait to see people breaking it. This releases next Wednesday, 2017, Top Stadium Club Baseball.
Fantastic. Rob, also this upcoming week, we have Hot in the Shop 2017 Leaf Trinity football cards. These packed boxes deliver 5 cards per box. All 5 cards are autographed. Look for on-card signatures from the top picks from this year's NFL draft, with a special emphasis on skill position players. And you may remember what I just said a little bit ago. A Leaf 1-of-1 Chris Bryant is on the eBay recently sold list for $30,000. So don't think that just because these are slightly different products that they can't bring the heat. Especially Leaf Trinity, always a great design. Check out those pictures. There are not only on-card signatures, there's also signature patch cards, which include large swatches from player-worn jerseys. The famous inscriptions that they feature on many of the cards, including a lot of the low number cards. And then one of my all-time favorite designs, Trinity Clear autographs, which typically grade very high and have a stunning acetate design with multiple tiers of images within the design, as well as multiple tiers of parallels throughout the set, numbered as low as 1-of-1. And they usually match the parallel with the color ink that the signer uses for those cards. They're always very unique and exciting. Players on the checklist include DeShone Kizer, Christian McCaffrey, Deshaun Watson, and many, many more. We see Dalvin Cook there, Mitch Trubisky, Joe Mixon. So I'm sure they've got a great crop of star young athletes and a very fun, exciting, hit-loaded football product hitting Hot in the Shop this week.
Brian Gray borrowed that color ink scheme from someone else. Do you know who the first trading card company to do that was, to match the parallel with the ink color?
Just for fun, I'm going to say it was Pinnacle.
Benchwarmer.
Oh, okay. There you go. So one that's still...
Yep. Left. Absolutely. Next up, another product from Leaf, this in the form of 2017 Leaf autographed football full-size football helmets edition. That's a mouthful. A package memorabilia product that has been a huge hit with collectors in the past. Each box will contain one autographed full-size replica helmet signed by either a Hall of Famer, current NFL superstar, or rookie. Each helmet is licensed by the NFL. Some of the names to look for: Walter Payton, Emmitt Smith, John Elway, Joe Montana, Peyton Manning, Dan Marino, Dak Prescott, Tom Brady, and many more. Don't worry, I don't think you can fit an auto pen or a helmet under the auto pen machine.
You went there.
This releases also next week on a day later on Friday, next Friday. That's it for that.
All right. Sorry, I'm still rocking and reeling from that nice. Also this week, hey, we get the gold standard in NFL football cards coming from Panini. 2017 Panini gold standard NFL football cards. Man, Rob, are you getting excited for football season?
It's starting to get there, isn't it?
So this is another loaded product, except there are 7 cards per pack. And only 5 of them are autographed or memorabilia. So there are some base cards in there. And at least one rookie jersey autograph numbered to 199 or less in every box. Now, Gold Standard has a really high-quality look to it. It's your shiny high-end product. So you know I like it. If you look at the images, you'll see that there are patches that are paired with gold ink numbered to 25 or less. Tags are paired with white ink numbered 1-of-1. Find rare and stunning Super Bowl diamond signatures featuring an authentic diamond. Chase 1-of-1 dual autograph versions as well. Good as gold autographs with prime versions. Gold jacket signatures that are paying homage to some of the greatest to ever put on a jersey as they don the gold jacket in this Hall of Fame autograph insert. Gold gear, white gold, bullion brand tags with massive laundry swatches. I'm talking this big. They're bigger than the card comes wrapped in the laundry swatch. All numbered to one of one. And then, of course, check your base cards for team and photo variations as well from the NFL's top stars and legends. I'll actually be looking forward to seeing a checklist of this because it'll be interesting to see who they decided to include, who was worthwhile from the veterans to make this exact checklist. So, very interesting.
And
I do... is.
I'm sorry.
Just a sell sheet. I won't talk about it. Just a sell sheet.
I saved the best for last. You know how much I love this product. 2017 Topps WWE Undisputed Wrestling Cards delivers 8 autographed cards and 2 relic cards in every box. This premium release for 2017 features top men and women's division WWE superstars, legends, and NXT prospects. Look for autograph parallels in bronze, silver, green, gold, black, red, and printing plates. Dual autographs numbered to 25. Triple autographs numbered to 10. Tribute cut signatures of classic WWE legends numbered 1 of 1. The always popular autograph kiss and shirt relic book cards. How about quad autographed book cards? Undisputed relic and autographed relics, also with parallels. Find a 70 card premium base set, multiple tiers of parallels, thematic subsets including women's division, 20 of the most iconic women's division superstars, and then dream matches. This is going to be interesting what they picked. 10 fan favorite matches that never quite happened in WWE history. 2017 Topps WWE Undisputed Wrestling Cards hits hobby shelves next Wednesday. And that's a look at what's going to be hot in the shop next week.
Very cool. I did have a quick question about the Stadium Club. Always such great imagery. Did you notice, though, that on the sell sheet they only showed landscape cards except for the autographs? I'm really curious how much of the set is landscape cards versus portrait.
That will be interesting to see. Hopefully we'll get a look at that. And obviously you'll hopefully, you know, you fans out there will pick up a box. And I'll be watching a couple breaks online at some of our favorite breakers just to see what's going on with that as well. So now we're going to go right into Ivan, read your notes. From Joe, we are going to, we had an opportunity to break a box today of 2017 Topps Walking Dead Season 6. With so much else going on, we put a flash break video together. It's pretty entertaining. I hope you like it. Warning, this video contains images of graphic violence, gore, and carnage. Viewer discretion is advised. We'll be right back. Welcome back, everybody. Welcome back, everybody. So what did you...
Work. Keep this place safe.
Help us!
Keep our families safe.
So we're all supposed to just fall in line behind you. Have to die before we do something.
Rick is dangerous.
These people, they gotta take care of themselves. Feel different about it?
Yeah, they do.
I know, Rick. I can stop.
We have to.
Life looks like now. I learned the voices. We have to fight it. Because if we don't, we die.
They're coming.
He's been out there. He's faced it. We are going to trust him. All of us.
Life, you will die.
Gotta keep moving.
Don't do it, man! The cup!
any idea who you're talking to.
Boom! Double booms out of that box of The Walking Dead Season 6. So we will be giving away the Carl Grimes autograph, numbered to 50. We will be giving away the one-of-one sketch card. Absolutely unbelievable. And we've got a bonus giveaway tonight.
What? Did not see that coming. The dog? You're giving away the dog?
No, I wanted to introduce everyone to the newest member of the Bertrand household. This is Bo. He's an 8 weeks old boxer that my wife just brought home today after having picked him out 4 weeks ago. The kids are excited, and if I don't return him soon, they're going to be mad. But say hi, Bo.
Hi, Bo.
He, he, he. All right, I'll be right back.
Oh. Okay, bye, Bo.
Hi, Bo.
I would go get mine too. I don't know if y'all can hear them. They're making quite a ruckus downstairs.
Oh, hey, family.
So we'll figure out. Rob, I just wrote you a little note. Let me know what you think. And that was amazing. Except no spoiler alerts. I still haven't gotten to watch the latest season because I'm a Netflix viewer.
All right.
Ain't nobody got time for that cable bill.
All right. So, James, get a screenshot of this.
Oh, that's good. Yeah, and that'll be fine. Just the one, I think. Is there any way to make that the large camera? The full camera? Or no need to do shenanigans otherwise. It's fine.
Hold on 1 second. There we go. Both cards. You got it, James?
Yes, sorry.
Okay. I'm going to assume you do. All right. Now is the time in the program where we take a look at some live box breaks. But we already have some things to give away. So in addition to these two things, Ivan, tell them about what they got to do to win the Walking Dead tits. We've got the National Sports Collectors Convention tickets. We've got the Prolific Pairs, Dak and Zeke. So I don't know if you want to do something before we dive into live box breaks or whatnot.
Well, I mean, we've got so many people here that entered for the Dak and Zeke already. Because, again, you enter by retweeting our pinned tweet on Twitter at GoGTSLive, twitter.com/GoGTSLive. That's how you enter. So if you have not already, go retweet the pinned tweet there. So that you can enter. So let's wait and let's do that after the box breaks and see what else we get. And then also, if you want to enter to win the National Sports Collectors Convention tickets, or if you know a collector that would love to, retweet that tweet. It's a little further back. You can just click the little media tab though and go back and see where that is in our tweets. And retweet that and tag a friend. Reply and tag a friend so that more people know that we're giving away 4 tickets tonight. A family 4-pack, or I guess one person can use it for all 4 days.
No, we're just giving away a pair today.
A family 2-pack of tickets.
The 4-pack was last time because we were off.
Weren't we off last week?
Yeah, and we gave away a 4-pack the week before.
Weren't we off the week before that?
No.
Oh, okay. Well, hey, I was never one for numbers. I am one for cards. So make sure you go out there and enter to win those, and we'll give those all away at the end of the show. And in just a minute, oh, it looks like it's been up for over a minute. So now the pinned tweets. You got to go find those other tweets if you want the chance of that. Oh, by the way, that Sage autograph dual auto of Zeke and Dak is numbered to 10. Numbered to just 10.
No, it's not.
That's a ridiculous hit, isn't it? Doesn't it say 05 to 10?
Oh, I'm sorry.
Yeah.
Yes.
Yeah.
You're right.
Numbered 5 of 10. Yeah, check that out. Check that out. So it's worth hunting to find that tweet if you haven't already, retweeting it. And now the Walking Dead Hits tweet is up. We'll give those each away to a different person, though, because there's so many Walking Dead fans.
All right.
And was there a bonus giveaway that I missed that you said?
No, not the puppy.
I'm writing all these things down. Oh, okay.
All right. That's right. Let's dive into Torque. One autograph or memorabilia card in every pack.
Five packs per box. So, yeah, that makes sense.
Nice.
Are you still there? Did I lose you? Yeah. All right. Well, I'll carry on because you got to get open in those. Yeah, so there's going to be 3 autograph cards and 2 memorabilia cards spread between these 5 packs, as well as 5 parallels and 5 inserts, including 1 clear vision in every box. So instead of doing their own clear vision for racing, there's a clear vision insert set. And you can find an autograph card from a top 5 driver in each inner case. Now, that's an interesting way to phrase it, because so who's number 6? Like, how do you really cut off top 5 on those? That said, Torque is known for jumbo items, materials, relics, including jumbo fire suit signatures with on-card autographs and oversized material swatches.
Oh, here's our
sheet metal signatures.
Here's a clear vision card of William Byron. The checkered flags are acetate, and the car image is die cut. That's pretty cool.
Love that. So it's because you got the black background, so it's tough to see how clear vision it is or isn't. So quad materials, metal materials, raced relics, and then Torque Prime Associate Sponsors, which are 1-of-1 jumbo patches featuring some of the best drivers that NASCAR has to offer. And then all of those memorabilia sets come in autograph versions and parallels numbered all the way down to 1-of-1, of course. And there is a full checklist if you go to GoGTS.net.
And our
GoGTS.net. You can see the entire checklist, download it in PDF or Excel format if you just want to use it as your checklist.
Our auto out of the first pack is a Matt Tiffett, number to 75.
If you can't beat it, Tiffett. What I always say.
It makes sense to me. Some nice close-up shots of the drivers in their full race gear, and then obviously their cars and primary paint. The always popular M&M car of Kyle Busch.
So who are the top 5 drivers, though, Rob?
That would depend. Yeah, maybe how they finished last year. Another clear vision card, this one a red parallel of Ryan Newman, numbered to 49.
And these are in the like 140 range, I believe, sort of where the box prices are.
Correct. Victory lap, numbered to 99, Kurt Busch. And we've got a quad swatch of Kyle Busch, numbered to 49. That'll be one we definitely give away. Be sure to get a shot of that, James. Let me move these out of the way here.
Wow. Kyle Busch quad patch. Numbered to 99, you said. 99 or 49?
49.
And sorry, because I wasn't quite able to see the whole thing. Up close, were they all suit patches, or was it some others?
Let's see here. The enclosed raced used material, guaranteed, blah, 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 blah. No, they're different. There is sheet metal. I do wish it said, because there are 3 different fabrics and sheet metal on there. 4 different pieces of material.
So the lucky winner will not only get a quad materials card. It will also have been thumbed by Rob Bertrand, the voice of the collector. The corrector. That's really what you should be. Not the voice of the collector, just the voice that is the corrector.
Pre-race parallel of Joey Logano, number 260.
Oh, interesting.
Boom! As much as she annoys me, I still like her. Danica Patrick, sheet metal auto, number 225.
Wow. Auto sheet metal.
I want to get a real good clear picture of this. Be ready,
number
James.
25.
Try one more time, you stupid thing.
At Danica Patrick. Boom.
Like she'll retweet it. Thank you, Rob. I got it.
Awesome.
What's her sponsor too? Is that Lowe's?
Aspen Dental.
Oh. Wow. You must be some dentist if you're getting into the at Aspen Dental. Your mouth, our mission.
I want to look at that again. That is a nice, nice card. She's got a good signature.
Some sort of Ponzi scheme or something? What is this Aspen Dental? This is crazy.
Ty Dillon, Clear Vision, number to 149. I love that these are one per pack.
Oh, Harold.
Dale Inman, just had to directing very, very traffic.
Funny but inappropriate comment.
Yeah, that card would be worth a lot more if she would actually win. I understand. I get it.
Larry had a hilarious comment. That's not sheet metal. That's tinfoil. These cars nowadays.
I still think it's funny that despite everything, she's still the face on the box. I digress. All right, two packs left. Two really nice hits so far.
Let's see if I can pull up a comp on that real quick while we're looking.
Here's another insert, trackside, Jimmy Johnson. Kevin Harvick, numbered to 100. Freaky fast from Jimmy John's.
So last year's out of 25 sold for 56 this past week, and out of 15 sold for 65. So I'm guessing that's like a $50 hit. That's pretty cool.
This is classy. Cale Yarbrough, Clear Vision. Really cool looking card. Camera doesn't do it justice. It's really cool. Directing traffic. Pit crew guys, 199. Danny Chocolate Myers. For Richard Childress Racing. Ooh. If you ain't bumping, you ain't racing, and you can see the scratch marks on this sheet metal.
There you go.
Duel of David Reagan and Landon Castle, numbered to 49. And it looks like a tire material up top. Very cool. And our last.
So just a reminder too, if you're just tuning in, make sure that you retweet our pinned tweet if you want a chance at the Walking Dead hits, if you want a chance at DAC and the NSCC show tickets. Retweet those tweets. You can find them in our most recent media. The way you win is you retweet in order to spread the word, and then you have to be watching live. In the chat room, and let us know if your name is the one called, if you're the random winner.
Rusty Wallace, Clear Vision, number to 99. Honor, what is it? Horsepower Heroes, Chase Elliott. And last hit, Spencer Davis Auto.
Who?
Spencer Davis. Spencer.
Yeah, who?
Who?
Spencer.
That's a Spencer card.
All right.
Right? Huh?
Okay. Anyone? So we will give away...
We're giving away the Danica Patrick and the Kyle Busch.
Yep. And the rest we will make sure go into prize packs.
Okay, so we're only giving away two, and then that's actually a great reminder, Rob, and for all of you out there. If you have not already, you can go ahead and enter to win our July prize pack is live. The link should be in our Twitter bio. If not, I will fix that as soon as we're done here, because I forgot to do that. But you can look through again. Go to the media tab, see our picture that has 7,000 different cards in it. And those are all the little sub hits and other things that come in, including some bonus things like the autograph card, a special collector's card that's designed to get autographed by your favorite players. There's various versions of that, and we usually give away a pack of those. Guessing there's probably some more upper deck GTS hot overtime wave three packs in there, which are an exclusive GTS exclusive upper deck parallel pack. So lots of cool things. So make sure that you enter our prize packs, and if you're like, oh man, I really wanted that other guy's auto, Spencer, make sure that you keep an eye out for the August prize pack, or maybe it might just make its way into a box of giveaways for the National. Who knows? So just one more reason to come to the National, see Rob's big box of giveaways. And yes, everyone, sorry for the echo. I'm so important, you got to hear me twice.
Don Ross Elite Football, two autographs, including one on-card
Pen Pals
autograph in every box. 5 cards, 20 packs. Let's rock and roll.
There will also be a memorabilia card in here, so actually 3 hits per box. And I know everybody's always curious on this. Looks like it's going for around 113 now, so not bad for a fun collectible product, a good set build with 3 hits in a box.
Boom, and right away our first hit is a David Johnson autograph. That's a solid hit right there. We'll give away that.
Oh, wow, very cool.
Thank you.
So I was just going to go into the rookies versus autograph versus veterans. Looks like there's some veteran autos right there. David Johnson. So I'm going to go double check the tweeter as well. Danica Patrick tweet is up and live. Go enter to win.
If you're just
37 tweets,
if you're,
so I'm gonna go, I'm gonna pick a winner from the last one too.
If you're just turning in for the
real quick,
yeah.
Let me also explain a bit more about this product. There are some cool new inserts in here, including throwback threads, both singles and duels, which are memorabilia cards with NFL legends numbered between 99 and 15. Pro Bowl standouts is a feature in this year's Donruss Elite, as well as epic materials, prime numbers, some fun field vision, face-to-face, spellbound family ties, insert sets, the parallels on rookie aspirations cards. So all the rookies are numbered to 499 or less, with parallels as low as 1 of 1, and die cuts, which are low numbered and hobby only. And then, of course, the autographs.
Wow, you aren't kidding, because here's one of Reuben Foster, numbered to 24.
Whoa, die cut. Rookie Reuben Foster, numbered to 24.
If you're just tuning in to GoGTS Live for the first time and are saying, what's showing us the base cards? The first few packs, we always do that so you can, guys can get an idea of the base design. I've had people tell me in our messages on social media, hey, don't be afraid to show the base cards. It helps me decide if I want to put the set together. So we are happy to oblige. And of course, we always like to show various inserts. You might have seen one pass by while Ivan was giving you some lowdown on the product. Man coverage, paying special homage to key defensive players.
And also keep in mind and use the hashtag base cards matter. Base cards matter, Rob.
Carl Lawson, some sort of prism action going on here. This card's numbered to 149. Very shiny. All right, so that is a look at some of the base and insert cards. Yeah. Boom! DeShone Kizer on card, hey. Pen Pals Auto.
Hey! There we go.
Got it, thank you.
Love that. That gets its own tweet, too. Jeff, you missed it, the 140 box of racing. Deshaun Kaiser, who won me over at the NFL Rookie Premier. If you watch my YouTube video, I should share that.
Rookie elitist Mitch Trubisky.
Absolutely awesome. Was that numbered or just base pen pals?
Base pen pals. On card.
I love how you're just you're so in the groove that you you didn't even you let us see it, but man, you were rocking and rolling to get back through these packs for our viewers. That's pretty
spellbound.
Fantastic. So make sure again that you check out Twitter. I'm actually going to steal that picture myself because that is so freaking cool. Wish that I'd hit that card.
Yeah, me too.
Yeah, go for it.
Yep.
Spellbound Aaron Rodgers. Nice. That's 2 years in a row with Elite that we've gotten top quarterback autos.
Yeah. Well, you know what's hilarious about that is, don't forget, so last year we pulled Dak Prescott. And we didn't really have a clue, though, that he was
right.
Dak Prescott, because he was early. Remember, he was a sleeper. Nobody, some people had some kind of expectations for him. Tony Romo was the quarterback, though, right?
Yep, college ties. Donta Freeman and Ricky Williams.
That said, and that was a red ink parallel, I think, numbered to 25. Or
yeah, that was sick.
We ended up, we got a second box from them, and in the second
Right.
We hit the Carson Wentz,
Jared Goff.
Who is the third quarterback on that?
Paxton Lynch. This guy right here. Speak of the devil. Jinx, you owe me a Coke.
Auto. We got a triple auto of those guys that we gave away. And then, like, 5 weeks later, it was like that Dak was actually the even hotter card than that triple auto. So we were super hot with this product last year. And it's very cool to see that we are hot with it again.
Another cool prism, number to 49. This one of Le'Veon Bell.
Awesome. Look at that. The tweet is up. Check it out.
Aaron Rodgers variation, looks like. Throwback.
Absolutely amazing. I'm going to share. If you follow me on Twitter at Watch the Breaks, I'm going to share right now that video of Deshaun Kaiser.
Boom! How about a Sammy Watkins dual patch number to 25? Look at that.
This was a good box.
Yeah, it was.
Good box for collectors.
James, you got that? We got to give that away too. Hold on. Best I'm going to do.
Okay, I got it. That's pretty cool.
So we got a Sammy Watkins number to 25 dual patch, a Deshaun Kaiser on card pen pals, and the David Johnson veteran auto. You can't do much better. That's a solid box. Solid box. Yeah, you should. I had to buy, you know, one of those, Ivan, those little metal luggage carts, you know, that you can strap something to and the handles telescope up. Yeah, I've got a storage bin full of product that I'm bringing to the National for activities on the Mike Berkus main stage, sponsored by eBay.
Ooh, it's about time, eBay.
The GoGTSLive crew will be there in full effect. Deion Lewis, number 267. Couple packs left here. Oh, nice. Field Vision. Carson Wentz. That's pretty cool. I like that. It's different.
That is a cool card.
It's different.
Sorry, I'm doing some admin.
Hey, you got to do what you got to do. How about home field advantage, Matt Ryan?
also, after this box, give me just a minute, because I got some Topps Walking Dead winners to announce, and I want to make sure that they're in the chat room.
Sweet.
So again, if you're just tuning in, because we're getting a lot of new viewers tonight, this is pretty awesome, everybody. The way you enter to win is on Twitter.
DeMarco Murray, number 71.
Through the tweets that we do, you have to retweet those. You also have to be watching to win. So make sure that you are sitting in the chat room, that you're participating, that you're logged in, so you can say yes. And then keep checking back in on Twitter.
Ryan Hill, number 499. And that wraps it up. So we are giving away the Sammy Watkins, the DeShone Kizer, and the David Johnson auto.
Sammy Watkins numbered to just 25. So again, go to GoGTSLive. Also, if you are new into the program, make sure you go back and retweet our Dak Prescott Ezekiel Elliott tweet and our national show tickets if you can attend the national in Chicago in just a few weeks to enter to win those. We'll be giving those away at the end of the show. So stay tuned for all of that. And go enter our July prize pack. There's so much to enter to win, and hopefully also enjoy the news, the hobby previews. Send a little tweet out thanking Panini for these great boxes of cards. Thanks Sage, who's coming up, and for their giveaways. And then thank Topps, who's got Museum Collection also coming along. Rob, give me just two more minutes. Say something fun and interesting, because I want to give Sage Autographed its full due.
No problem. I wanted to just clear the cache in the webcam there, because I agree with you on Sage Autograph. Sage Autograph has 12 packs in every box. Every box right on there says...
Well, that's what,
26 autographs in every box, two prolific pairs, cards included, and Chris Stratton at Sage was kind enough to send us some bonus material. Two of these cards will end up in prize packs. One we will give away as a guaranteed bonus with the Sage break tonight, and that is Training Days game worn shirt from the combine, this one of DeShone Kizer. Nobody else in football does this. These are actual materials worn by the athlete during the NFL combine, which took place
amazing.
On February 14th, 2017. We have two other ones of Huda Baker and Charles Harris. Look for those in those aforementioned prize packs that we put together every month. And so James, make sure you've got a picture of this. I'm holding on.
So go back. Where does that come from? Where's that bonus come from? Is that from each case has it, or no, they just sent it to you on top of it?
They just sent it as a thank you bonus. They appreciate us showcasing the product and wanted to be sure that we educate our viewers about the special nature of this particular memorabilia insert. Let me take it out of its sleeve for you.
The one thing I wanted to be able to have the full sell sheet up before we jumped into it, so I could, because if those are actually in the product, that's even
yeah. Oh yeah, maybe we might just pull one.
Like, let me ask you, and let's ask the audience, or actually even let's do a Twitter poll just for fun. What is cooler, an event-worn item or an actual, like, practice-worn or combine-worn item that they actually did work out in and do something in? Which do you like better? Obviously, we all love game-worn. If you had to choose, though, between event-worn and something like this, where they actually wore it to the combine, where they had something on the line, I think that's awesome. So I don't want to skew the poll results, though. Real quick, if you're in chat and your name is called, say hello.
Oh, you're announcing winners? Okay.
I'm announcing some winners.
Do it.
So that's what I wanted to get done just real quick before we dive into this box, because I want to be watching this entire box break for all 24 hits. All right, so the Carl Grimes auto. Let's start off big. Auto number to 50 from our Walking Dead break goes to David Panopoulos. Probably missaid that. We always do. David, are you crossing the border to come down and see us at the National? I hope so. So David, say hi if you're in chat. D-Pan. The one-of-one sketch card of Coral goes to Steve Wright, another good regular viewer of the show. That said, it's not always regular viewers. Guess what? The Kyle Busch number to 49. Well, he's somewhat well-known. Josh Ringler. Josh Ringler, are you watching? Say hello if you're watching so that we can give you credit for being in the chat room and give you instructions on how to claim your prize. And finally, so this is the new one, a new name for me. Danica Patrick Auto Sheet Metal number to 25 is going to a gentleman named Matthew Roble. Matthew Roble. So if you are watching Matthew in live stream or in Facebook, please say hello, and all winners can claim their prize by emailing GoGTSLive at GoGTS.net. I see you, D-Pan. And if I don't see you quickly, I'm going to pass on and pick some new winners because we got so much more to go over. So don't go out and like tag somebody and tell them unless you're the super nicest guy ever. Like make them watch the show. Make them be part of it to get these great hits. So
awesome.
Cheers. Let's rip open this amazing box. With all of these crazy giveaways.
All right, let's do it. The checklist is right on the back of every box of Sage Autograph Football, including the training days inserts as well as the prolific pairs. If you like those training day cards, you can look for other top picks, including John Ross III, Justin Davis, Samaje Perrin. Man, he's been on the books for a while. He's been in Upper Deck USA Football products, and now he's heading to the pros. Prolific pairs, extensive checklist, 25 different ones. There's an Ezekiel Elliott Donnell Pumphrey Jr. in there. There's a Patrick Mahomes Zay Jones. There is a Christian McCaffrey, Carlos Henderson. The list goes on and on. You know who I would like to pull? Juju Smith-Schuster and Darius Rogers. Let's see what we can do.
All right. So all of our winners showed up immediately. Thank you guys for making my job so easy tonight.
Wow, look at these packs. They're huge. They're like, I can't even fit it into the screen. They're like envelopes with little rip tabs. Cool. I can hear you with bated breath, Ivan.
I'm waiting. I hope the cards look as cool as what we got from Sage last time.
All right, pack number one. They do look great. Chad Kelly, number 10 of 10.
Oh, right out the gate. Quarterback.
Nice, so thick, premium like cardstock.
Do you want to put it in one pile, and then if it seems like a more base auto?
How about I go back through and we'll decide what to give away? Fabian Morrow, third round pick, cornerback out of UCLA. Michael Roberts, number to 25, fourth round pick. Oh, here's something I've never seen before from Sage. Boom. How about a Sage autographed authentic cut of Taco Charlton, numbered 1 of 1?
Who's Taco Charlton?
Come on. He's a first round pick for Dallas.
Oh.
Oh, well, I don't know this. And is that cut from a Panini card?
I don't know. It's cut from somebody else's card. Interesting.
That's super fun.
A taco. We're for sure giving the taco away. Yeah, that logo looks like a Panini logo. The RC there.
Let me bring that. First off, that's hilarious. Second off, that's actually pretty awesome in my mind. I think that's cool.
Nice. I don't think those were even on the sell sheet. Surprise, surprise. Hey, Training Days, John Ross, number 9 of 10.
Oh, A, you beat me to it. I was just going to say they also have those combine cards signed. And look, there you pull
boom.
Training Days.
Awesome.
What does it say? What does the inscription say on there?
The fourth. Excuse me. No, the third. John Ross, the third.
No, above the swatch. It has a date below, and then above it says
Rep 1 Training Center.
So it's actually they get that specific on it.
Yep.
That specific on it. Yeah, because I'm looking at some that just recently sold, like Charles Harris, and it came from his athlete's first training center.
Another autograph from a quarterback. This one numbered to 25 of C.J. Berthard.
Well, I know that John Ross has to go. That's amazing.
Yeah, Ross and Taco went into one pile already for sure. Justin Davis, numbered 1 of 10. Rookie free agent.
And I'll tell you what's crazy. If you're prospecting these cards, I'm looking at the sold, and they're selling for way too low. So if you're a prospect collector, I'm telling you, this product is going to be popping. And it's already, I mean, the price point for the boxes is over 300 for a box.
Look at that. Wait, what's 300 divided by 26 hits? Somebody do that for me real quick. Is that your?
Well, it's actually 320 or so.
That's your cost per hit, basically. Nice auto of Jamal Williams.
I'm just finding that there's some really
about $12.50 in auto.
Wow, that was good mental math. Just kidding. And I rounded up. They just can't hear you, James. So I was trying to make Rob seem
nice. Fourth round pick, D.D. Westbrook, number 5 of 25.
So I'm looking online. So the premium portraits are pretty popular. And the number to 10, Patrick Mahomes, sold for 50 from that.
Cooper Rush, rookie free agent.
I think he actually went to the Dallas Cowboys.
I think you're right.
Got signed by them. So if you think that the Dak.
D'Angelo Yancey, number 10 of 10. Oh, there's a prolific pairs. How about Christian McCaffrey and Patrick Mahomes, numbered 1 of 10?
Wow.
That one's going in the giveaway pile.
Yeah, this is crazy. I don't even think I need a review. I think that it's becoming apparent.
That's awesome. A Training Day signature, a 1 of 1, and a dual prolific pairs so far, and we still have several packs left. Brad Kaye.
So that one has sold before for $49.95. And imagine that's with just some hype on these guys.
Tyrone Swoops, like numbered at 25.
Oh, sorry.
It's okay.
Who is that?
Tyrone Swoops.
I forget that every card is a hit, so I don't have as much time to talk.
Obi Milifonawu. Not numbered, but he's a second round pick. Oh, another prolific pairs. This one of Chad Hansen and Ardarius Stewart, numbered to 10.
Wow.
I got that one.
Giveaway or prize pack? Giveaway or prize pack?
Well, one of the things, and I know that we've both been really absorbed with life, I think it'd be cool to maybe do it as a giveaway outside of a prize pack. We need to get more of those going again. I apologize to our viewers for not doing enough of that.
Look at that. Look at that. Samaje Perrin, Athletes First Training Center, February 14th, with that nice stitching on there.
Very cool.
Well, that goes in the giveaway pile.
So, Rob, let me ask you this. One of the things I was going to say is that I feel like this rookie class, even though there's some hyped guys, there's almost like so many kind of hyped guys that I feel like collectors are kind of waiting to see.
Oh, yeah.
Do you go for Mahomes? Do you go for Kaiser? It's not like in some years past when there was, you know, last year Zeke and Jared Goff.
Well, sometimes you got to roll the dice. I mean, people who got in early on Dak Prescott last year certainly paid off. Speaking of him here, is he in Zeke, who you just mentioned on a freshman Phenoms card? Yeah.
We should bundle that in with the autograph.
Okay.
Do a nice little fun packet for somebody. So I'm trying to find. I haven't seen a single one of those one-of-one cut autographs listed on eBay, sold or listed.
There's another infamous signer with an issue, Tekarist McKinley, numbered 1 of 10, first round pick out of UCLA.
Why do you have such a great name and then not sign it out?
Right?
What a great name.
Just Tekarist
McKinley.
Tim Williams.
It's like, own that. Speaking of which, pardon me for two seconds visually.
Sidney Jones, the fourth, numbered to 25, second round pick, cornerback, and Samaje Perrin again. Let's do a combo with the Samajes. Got that, Ivan? Boom. Single winner gets both of those.
Samaje.
Beautiful.
Which means that I probably got to go back to Twitter and start pulling some winners for these other things too, so that I'm ready to go. Oh God, we still have a museum collection to go. Man, this is a loaded show. I didn't think it was only four box breaks, but my God, when you got a box of 26 hits.
James Conner, running back, third round pick, numbered to 5. Corey Clement, rookie free agent. Running back, and our last pack of Sage autograph, which delivered in spades. Jeremy McNichols, numbered to 25, fifth round pick, running back, and rookie free agent Greg Ward Jr., wide receiver. All right, so to review, tonight we will be giving away the Samaje Perrin duel, the Tackerist McKinley, number to 10, the Patrick Mahomes Christian McCaffrey prolific pairs, numbered 1 of 10, the John Ross,
yes,
auto training days, number to 10,
the LBC.
The Taco Charlton 1 of 1, along with the freshman Phenoms.
I got it.
All right. You guys got some tweets to get going.
And that Deshaun Kaiser from the combine.
Oh,
yep. Bonus, right?
Where is that? Yeah. And we still have to give this baby away. Prolific pairs, Dak. Zeke, numbered 5 of 10.
Yeah. Very cool. Rob, do you have your phone handy? Is there any way real quick you could take a phone picture of that Taco 101 and text it to me?
I sure can.
That's such a unique card. I want to get a close-up look at it myself and tweet it out for myself. See how I'm commandeering material? All right, so I do have the winners from the Panini Elite. And this one will be hard to verify. Hard to verify, because your name isn't on your Twitter account. So you're going to have to verify. You're going to have to message, say hi in the chat room, and then tweet message us your name. Tastes like turtles.
Tastes like turtles. Welcome.
Tastes like turtles, who I've never seen before. You won the David Johnson Elite Auto if you are still watching. If you didn't go anywhere, if you stuck with us, you're watching. Or you're still here. So Tastes Like Turtles, not only do you have to say hi in a chat room and say, I am Tastes Like Turtles, you also have to send us a Twitter DM.
Which one did he win?
He won the David Johnson from Donruss Elite.
That one?
Or she won. Sorry to be misogynist. I made a mistake. Taste like turtles. I'm going to make sure that we're following this person.
Tweet is up.
Taste like turtles. Sorry, not taste.
Next winner?
The next winner of the Sean Kaiser auto is Brad B. Astros fan Brad B. Are you there? Are you there? And then Sammy Watkins out of 25 is Sleep Frank. Frank, you watching? Frank, say hi. You're generally watching. You're generally tweeting. We have a lot of fun with you. And Tastes Like Turtles, we are following you. So,
which product? James?
Oh, and there he is. There's Tastes Like Turtles. Thank you very much.
Nice.
So remember, send us an email, gogtslive@gogts.net. Thank you for verifying yourself. Tastes Like Turtles. Thank you for watching. I don't know if you've watched before, but we're glad to see you and have you be a winner. So you won the David Johnson Elite Auto. Brad B won the Deshaun Kaiser Auto, and Sleep Frank won the Sammy Watkins number 25. Sleep Frank, who I think I actually owe some beef jerky to also. I am a horrible person, and I apologize for being behind on things. That said, the Sage tweet is packed and loaded and up and already at 51 retweets in the span of 1 minute. Also, the event-worn, practice-worn relic card debate is going differently than I expected, Rob. That GTS question of the week is 86 votes, 60 are in favor of event-worn relics versus actual practice-worn relics.
Wow, I'm surprised by that. I really am.
Not what I would expect. Once we're done doing this next box break or doing the show, I may be able to go on Twitter itself and talk about that. But for now, I know that you're ready to rock, I'm sure. And thank you for your patience as we got all this crap done. It's not crap. We all love you. Are you ready to dive in, right? I can share what's coming up now.
Yeah, do it.
All right, so coming up now, we have 2017 Topps Museum Collection baseball cards, four packs per box, one autograph, one relic, one quad relic, and one prime relic card, plus parallels and a canvas collection reprint in every box. So we're looking for all-stars, we're looking for Hall of Famers, retired veteran, and rookie players here. Archival autographs, dual autographs, premium prints, gold autographs with black and white photography that are low numbered. Museum-framed autographs are one in every case, so keep an eye out for those. And then the autographs can vary between single player signature, swatch, triple relics, dual relics, jumbo patch autographs, oversized framed autograph patch cards, which are bonus hits, which means they don't count against your hits, I believe. That will highlight different relic pieces such as batting gloves, baseball cap logos, and team logo patches, all signed directly on card with gold ink and numbered one of one. Oh, please, mother of God, that would be amazing to catch one. And again, the reprints are in every box of the canvas collection cards. If you pull a canvas collection card, though, look closely, there are originals numbered one of one, which would make sense. So check those out right now as Rob gets them open. And I'm going to cut off entry for those, the DAC. I'm going to pull that winner now. Cut off entry for the, Oh, Larry, believe me, we tried to fix the echo. We tried. And it was a matter of show with echo or no show. And if you've seen the hits tonight, I hope you're tolerating the echo.
All right, we've got an Ernie Banks.
Oh, beauty.
Eric Hosmer. Hold on one second. Adjust some lighting here. Ken Griffey Jr. Noah Syndergaard. That's too hot. Hold on one second.
We're up to 90 retweets on the Sage giveaway, which again, it's for 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 different giveaways. That's crazy.
And our first hit is the quad patch from the Boston Red Sox. And this card is numbered to 75 with swatches from Xander Bogaerts, Hanley Ramirez, Mookie Betts, and Dustin Pedroia.
That's okay. Those are some kind of good patches.
I mean, I have a shot of it. It's blurry, but
yeah, I don't know why. All right, pack number two.
So many lines in those patches.
Probably not.
No, that's exactly why. Technical reasons only. That's what I get here. I'm here for the facts. Chris Bryant is the greatest baseball player ever.
Interesting. Frank Thomas. It's like there's a retired guy in every pack. Or two. Oh, that's a parallel, my bad. One parallel. Brooks Robinson.
Well, that's fun though. Fun though.
Gary like, Sanchez. Ted Williams. And our second hit, how about a Corey Seager dual swatch auto?
Yes, there's a good auto. Number two.
Got it.
Let's see.
I think you can get sharper than that, probably. It's on the front there. It's by your thumb.
50.
Number to 50. There we go. That's sharp.
Let me try for it.
Oh, it was sharp. It was there for a second.
Oh, I got sharp. I got real
sharp. Gotta be quick draw McGraw.
89.99. What a hit. 89.99 on the bay.
There's a Manny Machado parallel, numbered to 150.
And yet, Rob, I feel like you're all autographed out. You didn't give that one a boom. Especially not a jazzy boom. And my gosh, that's an awesome hit to have, I think.
Eh. Miguel Cabrera. Oh,
so you're letting your opinion get in here. I see what's going on. Hating on my Dodgers.
Chris Bryant.
Hey. Send that over here. I'm going to enter. Retweet. I just retweeted. I win.
And for you fans of the World Baseball Classic, Jurgensen Profer for the Netherlands, numbered to 75. And our last box. pack, mini box. Boom, Corey Seager, dual swatch auto. Are you happy?
There we go. It's back.
How about a purple parallel numbered to 99 of Matt Carpenter? Mark McGwire.
Hey, that's fun.
Hunter Pence. And canvas collection. Looks like to be Roger Maris.
Ooh, tell me it's numbered 1 of 1 and it's an original, not a reprint.
No, it's a reprint, sorry. And our last hit, Alex Bregman on card, number to 299. Boom.
Well, you got two autos? We got two autos in the box.
One on card autograph, one autograph relic, one quad relic, one jumbo relic. We got everything we were supposed to.
Yeah, I see. Autographed relic. Those words threw me off. Gosh. Well, hey, still, we got two good ones. So I'm guessing we got to give away both the Seager and the Bregman, right?
Yes, sir. Tonight. Leanna,
if you really want that Deshaun Kaiser auto and you win the Bregman, talk to Brad B. He'll probably trade you. So that'll be up on Twitter in just a minute. Don't forget, if you have not already gone to Twitter to enter to win the football hits from that Sage box. So many of them. Oh, my gosh. So that's what I'm going to draw right now is those winners. And that'll give you just enough time to get in a fast retweet on our Topps Museum Collection giveaway tweet. And then don't forget Dak Zeke Duo. What am I saying? Dak Zeke Duo autograph from Sage is a completely separate one. And we have the National Sports Collectors Convention pair of tickets as well.
Craziness.
First winner drawn. Stay in chat. You have to say hi in the chat to win. If your name is Tastes Like Turtles or any of our other winners, email us GoGTSLive at GoGTS.net. Hey, Buka Metal Art just tuned in. James Campanos as well. Also, we just announced a few about 20 minutes ago on Twitter, the winner, James Campanos, who's watching, gave back a hit because he won a pack and he got a hit in the pack. New York Rangers hit, so we just gave that away on Twitter. So always stay tuned on Twitter.
We did. Email me the address.
Yeah, I contacted the person and told them.
Oh, okay.
So, and then also something else that really fun shout out, Jeff Gwynn, who's watching and he's won before and he's helped out with some great stuff before. He did something fun. He sent out a tweet earlier and said, "Hey, first person to get in the chat room and say this." Wins, he gave away like 10 EA Sports packs, like a code for that. So just really cool to see all of you viewers engage as well. So
can I ask you something?
Yeah, absolutely.
I just want to... Topps Museum Collection, every box contains one on-card autograph. Check.
Yes.
One autograph relic. Check.
Yes.
One... quad relic. Check.
Oh, that's an actual box set. Gotcha.
One jumbo relic. Jumbo relic?
You're probably just missing a pack somewhere.
No, I'm not missing a patch. This should be... This pack should be... Or this hit should be a jumbo relic.
Oh, I see what you're saying.
It's a primary pieces. It is numbered to 75. It is wicked that it comes off the World Baseball Classic uniform, but I don't know if I'd qualify that as jumbo. Would you?
No, actually, here's the thing, Rob.
Okay.
According to GoGTS.net.
I'm reading it right off the box.
According to GoGTS.net, it includes one prime relic card. So my guess is, because that looks like it could qualify as a prime relic, a relic from a unique event, a unique jersey, it has more than one.
So that replaced the jumbo relic. Got it.
Yeah. That's, all right. That's my guess.
Fair enough.
That's my guess.
All right. So where are we at on giveaways? My gosh, I'm going to be busy Saturday morning, aren't I?
You're going to be Mr. Shipper. Mr. Shipperman. giveaways. Well, we've got the July prize pack that people need to enter to win.
No, I mean tonight.
I know. I'm buying time.
Oh, I'm sorry.
I've got the Sage winners picked. I'm just trying to reload the page so that I can get the tops winners picked. So if you didn't enter to win already, that one is going fast. So let's run through this super quick so we can get your names, because you got to be watching to win. So Terry Deck. Terry Deck, Deshaun Kaiser combine card. Alex Kent. Alex Kent, John Ross Auto, numbered to 10. Oh my gosh, I'm so jealous of you for that. Alex Kent, Terry Deck, say hi if you are in the chat room. Harold Denny, you may have been the big winner depending on how you look at these cards. You got the McCaffrey Mahomes numbered to 10, Harold Denny. Josh Ringler, I hope you didn't go anywhere because you actually got pulled again for the tank, the tack, the tack tack, tic tacs. The Samaji duo goes to our friend Jim Bayless. Used to be Jimmy Bayless. I guess he grew up. Jim Bayless. And then the Taco one of one goes to Jordan Grief. Jordan Grief, who I don't know either. So, again, everybody stop congratulating them so that they can say hi and I can see their names. We got Alex. Awesome. Love it. Alex is there. Alex is there again. Harold's there. Josh is there. So we're still looking for Terry Deck, Jim Bayless, and Jordan. So say hi. And then, Rob, I got to pick the museum winners, and then I got to announce the DAC and National Sports Collectors Convention winners. So all the winners.
Hold on 1 second. Did we do the John Ross Training Day winner?
Yes.
Okay. Did we do the Deshaun Kaiser Training Day bonus hit?
Yes.
Okay. The Ezekiel Elliott Dak Prescott Freshman Phenoms. This was supposed to be paired off with something.
Yeah, with the other Ezekiel Elliott autograph from last year that we're giving away.
Oh, this. Okay, right there.
Yep, so I just figured it makes sense. So Terry said hi on the live stream, so thank you, Terry. So we're still missing Jim Bayless. Jim Bayless just said hi on live stream too. So Jordan Grief is here. So Jordan, welcome. I don't know if it's your first time watching. I haven't seen you before. Make sure you follow me at Watch the Breaks and let's interact and have some fun. And now, Rob, because my internet is so freaking slow because of the bandwidth that I'm using for this, you're going to need to talk for like 3 minutes while I pull these last two winners for the Seager Bregman, and then we'll be good to go.
All right. Looking at the programming notes over the next couple of weeks, the week before the National, Thursday the 20th, will be our National Sports Collectors preview show. Excuse me. We'll give you a complete guide to what to expect if you're attending the show, and if you're not attending the show, what to be looking for on eBay to pick up for your PC that other people will be picking up and invariably flipping if they don't collect them. So that the National Sports Collectors Convention pre-show show will be July 20th. Over the next couple of weeks, we're going to be looking to bring on some people from the National to give some details about some of the events that are going on. As a reminder, be sure to visit nsccshow.com to register for VIP passes and the Dick Butkus meet and greet sweepstakes. New product previews this week to look for on GoGTS.net. Wow, I can hear myself now. That was really weird.
Yeah. Well, Rob, you've earned some echo for putting up with me this whole time.
To give you guys a rundown of some of the product previews that hit this week, Panini Origins NFL football cards, Leaf Sports Icons Cut Signature Edition, Leaf Memorabilia Vault. Also, next week we'll be looking at a Future Watch segment with a guide to collecting Ben Simmons NBA basketball rookie cards and a look at some of the amazing prices his non-autographed, his just base and base parallel rookie cards are going for on eBay.
That's cool. Rob, real quick, too.
Yeah.
And we'll get back to that because, again, we got some lag, we got some delay. We got to announce these names, though. So the first one, the Bregman auto numbered to $299, goes to another new user that I haven't seen before, Fitch Junior 1, or Fitch JR 1. So say hi if you are watching Fitch JR 1. I did see a, someone named Fitch talking. It was not Bethany Fitch, who I normally, she's a part-time listener. Also, then the Corey Seager dual auto is going to AJ Zaps, who's generally usually watching. And again, apologies for the echo, everybody. We'll try and have it sorted out by next week for your sake. Thank you so much. Hey, looks like Dave Fitch is Fitch JR1. So those are those two winners. And then, so we got Fitch here. See if AJ Zaps is still watching. He usually is. So I'm going to announce the other winners, and then I want to plug Future Watch a little more because I feel like we haven't talked about that in a while and people are missing out. So, Rob, the National Sports Collectors Convention tickets, do you have those? Can we show those to the audience? Or the freshman phenom, Zach D. Okay, oh, never mind. I'm watching on the delay and you switched. You're good. You are smart. Absolutely love it. The National Sports Collectors Convention tickets go to viewer Dave Michener. Dave Michener, say hi if you are in chat. Let us know that you will be claiming those tickets, that you'll be using those tickets. Again, the email is GoGTSLive@GoGTS.net. And now the Dak Zeke numbered to 10. This one makes me happy because he's done a lot for the show as well in support. And also, he got some other good news this week about his hot dog being a finalist for the Fenway Park thing. Mikey Bedell. Mikey Bedell, who may soon have a hot dog that he designed selling at Fenway Park, we will know soon, was the Dak Zeke number to 10 winner. I see AJ in the chat room. Hey, AJ. And again, the email is GoGTSLive@GoGTS.net. Include your shipping information. Let us know what you won so that you can help keep track of things for Rob and me and the shipping department. And Rob, again, so the email is GoGTSLive@GoGTS.net. GoGTSLive@GoGTS.net. And it's easy to remember because, again, GoGTS.net, if you're not using it for your as a card resource, you are missing out. Rob is...
Look what we gave away tonight. Look at that.
That's crazy. 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 We get articles from Russ at Sportsology. We get lots of guest articles. Casey Schroyer, who used to work for ESPN, writes articles. And these future watches are great things to do if you're into prospecting. If you open a box of Sage and you're like, well, who's this guy that I got an auto of? Who is Taco Kanata or whatever his name was? Well, you can go on Future Watch and you can see player profiles of up-and-coming prospects, stars, especially if you're in hockey and you get a rookie you don't know who they are. Future Watch is the place to be, and that's on GoGTS.net. That said, I'm pretty sure that we saw everybody.
Awesome. Well, that's going to wrap it up for this edition of Go GTS Live. We thank you for tuning in. This show is about the hobby, and it's for you. Thank you to Top, Sage, and Panini America for providing us product to share with you. Please let them know you appreciate that on Twitter or Facebook or both or Instagram or all three. Special thanks to the Asset Associate Producer, James Gale, our producer, Joe Fallon. We'll be back next week with a brand new episode of Go GTS Live. It's all about the hobby. Always be collecting. Have a good weekend, and we will talk to you later.